One, two, three, four, five.
Nelson Mandela once said, if education is the most powerful weapon that we can use to change the world. By saying this, Mandela is telling us that if we are uneducated, we are weak and unable to take on the problems that we will soon face. Education is one of our greatest tools, and if we choose to utilize it, nothing can stop us. In that case, what are we waiting for? If education is one of our strongest tools, then why are we debating whether or not to extend the school days or school periods? According to the National Center for Education Statistics, there is approximately 3.3 million students that are graduating in the year 2014-2015. Now, according to this source, that means that we are empowering approximately 3.3 million young adults. The real question here is if we gave them enough time to prepare themselves for what's really out there. Today I'm going to talk about the extension of class times and periods, the importance of holiday, break, and vacation times, and the benefits of year-round schooling. Let's start by examining the length of class times. Increasing time spent at school may be useful for students to learn and comprehend the lesson being taught, and according to education sciences, theory and practice, time spent on activities increases learning. In extended lesson hours, teachers allot more time planning work time and strategies. With more time allowed for a lesson, students absorb more info on a deeper level. Comprehension can come quickly and easy for some students, and they don't require much help from the teacher. However, others are not as fortunate. Some may take up to 20 questions later to understand what the lesson's actually talking about. Another benefit of extended hours is longer time for hands-on learning. One of the many ways students can be taught is through hands-on learning. Whether it is dissecting an insect or learning how to hold a tool, hands-on learning is an excellent strategy. According to the Advanced Research Improving Education, the said school standard is 170 to 180 days long, 5 days a week, and 6.5 hours per day. If we need to add time but it interferes with anything outside of schedule, they may use a modified schedule, such as block scheduling. The class period of a block schedule is longer than the traditional 50-minute period. It is around 84 minutes. In my experience, science classes have labs, and they may not be long enough to cover all the material needed. I've taken many science courses in my high school career during the 84-minute blocks, and it is much easier to participate in the lab and get finished, although not all questions may be answered. Through this is why it would be useful to have extended class periods. Now that we've seen how important classroom is, let's look at how holiday breaks and vacations affect the students and their ability to learn and retain information. Breaks, holidays, and vacations are essential in every schedule. You cannot completely eliminate these vacations or breaks because everyone needs one. Studies have been conducted on parents and teachers in the Bursa area asking about whether they feel the current break times are sufficient. According to the Educational Sciences Theory and Practice, 55.8% of parents found that summer vacation was sufficient and covered enough. However, less than half of the teachers found it sufficient. They believe that it's taking away necessary time in the classroom. Turning now to my visual aid, you can see how the breaks balance out. Summer vacation is 60 days long, and on a balanced calendar, it can be 30 days long, thus eliminating the space where students could lose information. Many reasons breaks are necessary, but time allowed isn't. For example, Dr. Karen Walker, who wrote the research brief on year-round school, states that breaks are important and that they can be adjusted according to the schooling schedule. There are two types of modified schedules, the multi-track system and the single-track system. Let's begin with talking about the multi-track system. This system goes year-round and involves every 10 weeks of school, you get a 2-week long break with a 4-week summer vacation. It is easier for the students to remain interested in the courses they are taking as the periods are shorter. In the single-track system, it is very similar to the multi-track, only the main difference is spacing out of vacations. Rather than going 10 weeks with a 2-week break, it would have 45 days with a scheduled 15-day break, and they would also have the breaks between courses. With different options for school scheduling and class periods, let's see how beneficial these changes would be. Many of you are on the fence as to deciding if it should be implicated or not, so here are just a few benefits to go along with year-round scheduling. Setting up your school schedule in quarters or trimesters would allow you to fit more courses in throughout the year. This would allow students to take classes that they're actually interested in, not just to fill up space in their schedule. It would also allow the more advanced students to earn college credit throughout the year. Another good reason is if you fail a course, you can also make it up during the same school year while the information is still fresh. And it might be easier for you to absorb the information since you just got out of the course. It also saves time for you because you can retake the class in the same year rather than waiting till the next year to take it. There is also less academic loss. According to Kelly Charlton, who wrote The Effects of Summer Vacation on Achievement Test Scores, a Narrative and Meta-Analytic Review, the study indicated that the academic loss over one summer equaled out to about a month on a grade level, or about 1/10 lower than the previous test score. Teachers must spend extra time reviewing material because of this information lost, and it wastes time when they could be reviewing going over new information. Today I've talked about the importance of class time and how you use it in a classroom, the allotted time for breaks and holidays, and how the benefits of year-round schooling would be essential to a student. As Nelson Mandela once said, education is our most powerful weapon. So why are we debating to empower our students or not? Thank you.